Okay, thank God's Friday. Mga usaping dapat nating pagtuunan ng pansin. Ito po ang isyu at serbisyo. Hatid sa inyo ng PTV Cordillera. Sa ating pong talakayan ngayong hapon kay Elian, makakasama natin ang ina na ngayon siyang nakatutok sa pagnenegosyo dito'y Cordillera at maging sa kapakanan nating mga consumer. At para sa karagdagang detalye, kaugnay sa magiging takbo ng ating diskusyon, narito ang ating kasamang si Febe Kate Valdez.
Ado din naawanan iti pagbiagan kapo iti panagtama ti COVID-19 pandemic. Kalpasan tinasurok makatawan na pandemya, at dumatan dagiti nakasubligan na adaan iti trabaho, tapno makalasat iti financial akarit iti daytoy a krisis. Sakbay pa iti pandemya, addan dagiti programa ti gobyerno, at umultulong kadagiti micro, small and medium enterprises manu MSMEs, tapno mapatibkar dagitoy ken mabukol pa iti kanayunan na job opportunities ditoy pagilian. Para matkadagati agtutubo. At dati Republic Act No. 10679, when the Youth Entrepreneurship Act, amang isuro kadagitoy, tapno at adang agbalinda a produktibo, babaan iti panagnegosyo. Iti programa apondo sa pagbabago at pag-asenso. Matulungan dagiti babasit ang negosyante iti intero a pagilyan, babaan iti panangpaay iti pautang at daan laeng, iti 2.5% ka interes tunggal bulan. Dahito'y kat mabalin na mausara dagiti negosyante para iti naparapratak apan ng paturas da iti negosyo dagitoy. Pagsagsagan na andamot itati impakabsat regional trade fair, apaka itampukan dagiti produkto dagiti MSMEs ti rehiyon, akas iti furniture, handicrafts, kantaraon. Ita parang ti isyu at serbisyo, maamuan tayo pa'y dagiti ng duduma a programa ti Department of Trade and Industry Cordillera, babaan ka ni Regional Director Juliet Lucas. Para iti isyu at serbisyo, Fevi Kate Valdez.
Hashtag DTI Cars sa IAS. Let us all welcome Department of Trade and Industry Cordillera Regional Director Ma'am Juliet Lucas. Ang ating kailan po mula sa Bauco Mountain Province na yung Bagnamalam. Welcome sa ating show, Director Lucas.
Salamat, Sir Eddie. Na yung bagmat nga malam tayo amin, all the listeners of Isyu at Serbisyo dito sa PTV4.
Iti pagsasaot iti Mountain Province niya tinimbaga malam ma'am.
Gawis ay
Masdam.
Masdam.
Gawis no.
Gawis.
Gawis ay Masdam.
Gawis is good.
Okay. Ma'am, almost ilang years na datay latamat iti pandemic ano? Stage ket anya ba iti kang runaan nga almost 2 years na no.
2 years.
Anya ba iti kang runaan nga akem or tututukan iti Department of Trade and Industry kas pasad datoy COVID response. Ano yung particular na involvement ng Department of Trade and Industry Director?
Okay, so we are more concerned dito'y kwangay, dito'y economic recovery.
Mm-hmm.
So we have heard and saw from the surveys nga ado tinag-close, partially opened, ado pa'y tinawanan ti trabaho da. So it's on economic recovery. So we have packages nga in tweak mo dagiti regular programs me to address dagitoy panag-rise manan dagitoy nga negosyo. So first in the list is of course yung mga financing program, and then we also have livelihood packages. But in the department ti consumers dagitoy rolling store tapno handang nga umay kadagiti downtown or center trading centers tapno to do away with the crowding kadagiti marketplaces. So dagitoy iti first line of defense tayo, so we brought the rolling store, diskwento caravan to where they are. Tapno handa nga mapangumatang kadagiti merkado nga crowded.
Mm-hmm.
Oo, so dagijay pay Sir Eddie na aramid me so far. Kat, aside from the negosyo center programs that we are also implementing, kat we are making strategies nga to address the pressing concerns of buying and selling, kat iso dito yung makunkun na nga online,
okay,
e-commerce, etc.
Okay, as far as economic recovery is concerned, we are focusing more ba sa mga negosyante to, yung mga entrepreneur, or kami mismo rin, tayo mga consumers din dito, ma'am?
Both side yan, sir, because DTI is flip side. two sides of the coin, no, for regulatory and of course developmental. Developmental, the client, the Department of Trade and Industry are the businesses, but more on, kasi regional operations kami, so more on micro, small, and medium enterprises.
Okay.
So, iti other side mo, we have to see to it that the consumers are protected. Mm-hmm. They are safe and they get the value for money.
As far as statistics is concerned, Ma'am Juliet, at dabati, parang ratio tayo no... Manot it direct nga naapektara mo dito Cordillera as far as pandemic is concerned, parang ganun?
Okay, so at the onset of the pandemic, about only 10% were sustained, no? Mga 47% were partially open or under capacity. And then mga 53% were closed, and especially on the tourism businesses.
Oo.
To which all of our provinces and CAR are involved, no? So DJ.
Sa bagay, so matgamin ti kuat kang runaan, matgamin nga pagbiyagan niya. Pagbiyagan. No, di ti Cordillera, no saan nga tourism, particular ti Baguio, ti Benguet kat, dagito'y agriculture. Yan.
And that is corroborating, kasi anything about tourism is clustering other industries, eh. Pati
yes, ma'am.
Pati craft tayo, dagiti travel, etc. Food. Mm-hmm.
Ma'am, let's proceed tayo. Ano? Mag-shift lang tayo sa issue naman. Yung mga kangrunaan nga programa naman, just to highlight itong mga, what do you call that, centerpiece natin or benchmarking or best practices. At isa-isayin po natin, ma'am, ano? As we go over them one by one. Rugyan tayo, ma'am, dito'y negosyo center program nang nasabi ngayon siya. Nayuswat tayo do 2015, ano? Oo. So, kumusta na? Ano ng status ng operation natin, ma'am?
Okay, so lahat ng mga negosyo centers natin did not stop. So, they were all operational ever since, no? Even during pandemic. Kasi they are the first contact dagiti negosyante iti grassroots. It's actually the grassroots approach of DTI. These negosyo centers are large ngay dito'y dagiti kadagiti munisipyo to bring our services closer to the people where they are. So the first program of negosyo center is mainstreaming dagitoy MSMEs to our economy by way of registration. When we register our businesses, of course, we are listed, we are placed in the statistics and in the database, and so we get enough intervention from government. And to think that we have a complete interventions, menu of interventions from different agencies, including DTI. So at the negosyo center, we have also a lot of information or activities to capacitated dagiti MSMEs tayo.
Okay.
In terms of entrepreneurship mindset, yes. So aside also from skills development that will improve their products and productivity.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so with that, we also do counseling, we also do training. But during the pandemic, Sir Eddie,
what happened?
Because we saw the shift and the need for online selling.
Yes.
The sellers went to online selling.
Naging in demand yun, no?
Oh, and the buyers also oray shakot naging kwa suki akiti online. Oh, di ba? Mind ka pa ijay kwa live selling ka kasi jay. So
yes.
Yeah. So with that, we also concentrated or focused our capability building iti e-marketing or improving their knowledge and
yung enhancement on, no?
enhancement. And aside from that, of course, to let them be secured with what they are doing, especially dagiti consumers kan dagiti sellers mat kasi cybercrime or fraud in terms of online selling kat. It's either on the part of the seller, it could be also on the part of the consumer. So both ways, oo.
Napagandang pag-usapan din natin mamaya, ma'am, dito cyber, anya?
Yeah, cyber.
Ado naging mabiktima. Now, just to some point of clarification, ma'am, yung negosyo center program, definitely, you tie up with the LGU. Datoy, you know, kasi sabi niyo, lodge with the municipalities, gano'n.
Yes, because they provided us the venue.
The venue.
So, dagiti LGU Spiman, they accommodated us and we have a memorandum of agreement that we help each other.
Okay.
So, doon sa kanila, they have the list of licensed businesses.
Ayun.
And so, we also bring them into business registration. So, magkatuwang po kami doon.
Hmm.
Yung maganda kasi sa registered yung businesses, Nasa listahan ka eh kung naghahanap ka, naghahanap ang gobyerno ng kung sino ang tutulungan, edi pupuntahan mo listahan, di ba?
Yes.
Which our business counselors who are located or doing who are working at our negosyo center could that is their main reference.
Okay. At the same time, legit, no?
Yeah,
you have this master list nga. Oh, dagitoy, dagiti negosyo nga legit, han nga house show, han nga...
Oh, tama ka, may, sir.
Tama ba? Tama yung punto
sir.
Ko. Now, let's proceed, ma'am. How about itong implementation ng livelihood seeding program, negosyo serbisyo sa barangay?
Okay. So that is also a grassroots package nga negosyo serbisyo sa barangay. It means it's some sort of a caravan. Pupunta kami doon sa barangay, kakausapin si Kapitan, tapos i-orient namin sa mga tao o sa government official yung mga services ng government for economic development. After which, doon naman sa barangay na yun, we profile potential businesses. Potential, yung mga tao doon na nakinig na may potential na maging businessman. So, we also get their business plans and seeding means we are going to provide them a little package of in terms of goods.
Okay.
Nga iso ti pagrugyanda nga agnegosyo.
So goods. So walang monetary doon.
Wala po. Bibili po ang DTI doon sa ni-request nila na gagamitin nilang pang-start ng negosyo.
Okay.
So that's seeding, no? When yung ibig sabihin ng seeding is we have to start with a business that will grow. Yun okay. Ang objective natin, mag-grow yan into something that is profitable.
Ma'am, sa ating monitor, sa ating umiikot na videos, ano yan, ma'am?
Ay, ito, nagdala po tayo ng machine.
Wow.
Shared service facilities yan. Nagagamitin din nila.
Coffee? Yes.
Talagang dinadala natin yan to where they are. Ni-request ni Lion. And it so happened that this one is a coffee community that is located across the river. So, grabe. Talagang dalhin natin. So, mano-mano pa lang pagdala nila. But anyway, they brought it already. So, we hope this community will be producing good quality and maganda yung production capacity nila.
Wow, ang galing ha. Sige, ma'am. Let's proceed sa iba pa mga magaganda yung mga programa na, ma'am. Anyamat, dato'y shared service facility.
So that's the one. Okay. So yun sa livelihood seeding program, yung startup goods, no? Goods. Kung bakery ka, baka arena, or sugar, or what. Kung ano naman, kung sari-sari store, some goods, no? So ito namang shared service facilities. Ito yung, when there is an industry in a certain community, magpo-propose sila. Organization yun. Kailangan kasi organization yung mag-propose. Mag-propose sila ng kailangan nilang equipment para gumanda ang produkto at saka maganda yung productivity. Yung ginagawa mo ng isang oras, kung dati ay 10, magiging 100 yan or 1,000.
So mag-propose?
Magpo-propose
sila. Saan yung isasubmit?
Propose nila sa DTI.
Ayun.
And then we purchase the equipment and then deliver it to them, monitor the productivity and production.
Okay.
So marami na tayong mga projects diyan, 165 in all in the entire Cordillera.
Okay. Thanks for sharing, ma'am. Napindas gayam datoy. At isa yeah. Dito makamamo datoy shared service facility, ma'am.
For food processing, for sugar cane, for dapat yung organic fertilizer production kasi naging kwa tayo ngayon, naging concern tayo iti health, so they need that.
So, ado gayam niya? Ado pwede eh?
Yes.
Kaya dad dumapay nga mabalga pagsayatan. Ma'am, before yung ating gap, ito, yung Industry Cluster Development Program. Anyama, titaray na dati ma'am nga operasyon.
Okay, so, industry cluster is enhancement. Is we have to enhance an industry that is existing in a certain community, no? So in the region, we focus on cacao, coffee, favorite ko ata siyak ti coffee princess garud.
When?
Okay, so coffee, processed fruits and nuts, home styles and wearables, and then we also have bamboo.
Okay.
Bamboo. So those are the focus industry because of our resources and the interest of the people. So with that, we profile the industry. Get the different stakeholders here and look at their needs. Yun ang What are the gaps of the industry? Yun ang i-address natin.
Okay.
With our different programs sa negosyo centers, sa OTOP program,
one town, one product.
Uh-huh. Yeah, because our objective here is to make the industry progressive in a way that it can contribute to the economic development, the employment of a certain community.
Okay. Based on your statement, ma'am, at in line with this various programs ng DTI no, na na-cover natin, eh, hindi pala rin naging hadlang despite itong pandemya ang ating kinakarap. Eh, pustro talaga.
Mm-mm.
At with this active involvement ng iba't ibang mga stakeholders naman dito. Government, lalo na yung mga tao sa komunidad. Ma'am,
yes.
Okay. Tintay para gusubli, papagayam, sumarunumat nga pagsasaritaan tayo, dagiti programa ti DTI Cordillera nga nakatutok ka dagiti agtutubo. Oy, kami ba yun? Sa mga kabataan, mangayat nga makasursuro, iti panagnegosyo. Yan. Di kayo ang sukat tapo ti channel, dito ay ket ti isyu at serbisyo.
Umno. Gusto kan alisto a panagipadamag. Si kami di mapagbiaran. Para iti pagilian.
Hashtag DTI Cars sa IAS with Director Juliet Lucas, the Department of Trade and Industry, Cordillera. Kailan doon dadag iti saludsod, concerns we no komento na kaya't yung ipadanon iti sangaili tayo. Mabalin kayo latamag nag-text kada iti numero nga makita yung iti TV screens. Yan, no? Nasa baba, no? We no komento iti live stream tayo, iti PTV Cordillera YouTube channel. We no official Facebook page tayo at PTV Cordillera Public Affairs. O ito, Director, may pumasok na po agad-agad, ha? Na katanungan, manipod kini Winter Gayaw. Kumusta po daw ang pag-monitor sa mga online food and dry foods delivery? Salamat na Summer.
Okay, so...
Mga dry goods sa delivery.
Dry goods delivery dito, ayan tayo. So, since the opening of since the pandemic, hindi naman masyadong na-hamper itong food deliveries natin.
When?
Especially if it is essential. So, this is being addressed by the food passes. So, awan mo tikod. But we are monitoring the prices of basic necessities, kan essential goods tayo.
Mm-hmm.
So, during calamities also, we do also monitor the nagitingay supply situation. So, we see to it that hindi tayo kukulangin just in case there is obstruction of deliveries.
Okay.
But that's what we see. And as of now, we have, according to our monitors, we have adequacy of basic necessities, no?
Such as?
BNPCs, like
yes, ma'am.
Yung mga food items natin na noodles, sardines, sugar, etc. So, basta basic to our home use, okay? So, yung dry goods naman, we are not monitoring it kasi it's not among the listed BNPCs.
How about sa part ng mga crops, ma'am, yung sa mga vegetables, sa DA na yun,
DA
no?
Po.
But
DA
you have
DA
this
po.
Collaborative ka din, ma'am?
Yes.
Constant communication
yes,
with them?
Yes, yes. Because doon kasi sa LGUs, LGU level, we have what we call the LPCC.
What's that, ma'am?
Local Price
Monitoring Council.
Coordinating Council. So, we usually do it jointly and we support each other.
Yes.
Although kung sino yung may jurisdiction, sila yung nagte-take care sa mga cases or mga issues that are coming out.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. Ma'am, let's take your summer, huh? And let's proceed, ma'am, sa negosyo or programa para kay iti youth.
Yeah.
Or agtutubo, particular itong youth entrepreneurship program iti opisina yo, madam.
Yeah, dito yung car, it is something unique kasi ada nga DJ survey ID among our industries. Kati average age of our craftsmen, our industry workers, or those who are producing, 57, Sir Eddie, 57. So we have our desire to make it young, to make the industries young, and infuse innovation, creativity through our young minds, of course, with the reference also of the wisdom of the elders.
Okay.
So, tatta nga year, DJ, mentoring program tayo, Kapatid Mentor Me or KMME, we focused on the youth edition. We call it the youth edition. So, two batches of that were mentoring of a total of 105. Mm-hmm. 105 youth spread across the provinces dito yung Cordillera. Dagitoy, they are into food businesses, they are into retailing, they are into handicrafts and so forth. No, yeah. So we accommodated them, and it was very fun. It's very inspiring because they do it fast. When they start a business, they do it fast. May nakita ako nag-present after the graduation. They came up with a milk tea stall, and then it's a sustainable it's earning her sustainable income.
Okay.
At that time, nag-put up the cafe na dito natong Tilan Bank, dito yung Marcos Highway. Nag-put up iti cafe, and it's doing good. DJ, may samot nga ubing, so nainganyo iti panagaramid iti chili, ta chili ti iti ipoproduce DJ, DJ Tatang na. So, he added value by processing it. So, si Chut, kuna na iti nga branding. Ang gaganda ng mga brands nila. So,
yes, ma'am.
It's very inspiring because they do innovation. Okay, so...
Based on the monitor, ma'am.
Oh, yun.
Maka may ada programa yun sa dito, iti may isang hotel. No? That's a seminar or orientation
actually,
ba?
Actually,
or...
that's their graduation where they earned their, wow. Certificates of graduation para silang nag-graduate ng masteral.
Mm. And I understand hindi lang kayong mga taga DTI, yung mga lecturers or speakers nyo came from...
It's not us. Actually, it's not us because we tap dagitoy experienced businessmen who are sharing their experiences, wow, and business, failure and successes.
Mga ups and downs nila.
Ups and downs nila. Wow. Doon sila natututo. So practical. Galing. Practical knowledge ang ating binibigay sa kanila. So, 12 modules yun, Sir Eddie.
Okay. So, anong outcome? Yung involvement ba ng mga youth na to, kabataan sa pagninegosyo? Mas nainganyo ba sila?
Tama. If you go to a long session road, marami na sila doon. So, yung karamihan sa kanila, yung mga business ng mga parents nila, in-enhance nila, pina-improve nila, pinaganda nila yung mga produkto. Hmm. And they are very active in the selling, in marketing because of our social media, okay, or online marketing.
So do you think nakatulong din itong pandemic na naging madiskarte ang tao, yung mga kabataan? At the same time, ma'am, meron na rin notion kasi sa PMAP, yung Philippine Management Association of the Philippines, na mas gusto na yung mga kabataan ngayon pagka-graduate, ayaw nila magtrabaho sa company, gusto nila maging entrepreneur or
negosyante. Yes, and be the bosses.
Okay.
Of themselves, and they were the bosses, they are the managers, and they are very quan, they are very innovative in managing also. And it's not the old school, no, yung mga very structured na organization. They want it simple,
yes,
and hitting the solution for the life gaps in our society. So,
okay,
ang nakikita nila mga may solution, sinusolusyonan nila, and that, we call that a startup.
Oo.
The startup, kung may nakikita nilang problems sa society, yun ang i-invest nila.
At saka iba na yung kabataan ngayon.
Oh.
Iba na dahil as I observe, kasi may anak din ako na na-involve na rin sa entrepreneur, no? Sa ganyang negosyo, sa pagbebenta, sa online, and so on and so forth. Parang naging, what do you call that, yung independent at the same time, malaking tulong sa tingin nyo ba talaga ang SOCMED, social media, to promote one's business?
Yes, because everybody, like every one of us here, are always glued at our cell phones, right?
Yes, yes.
So everybody is, almost everybody is doing that. And in the Philippines, 95% are doing it, and they always look at the social media.
Mm-hmm.
So we would like to capitalize also on the use of social media to do promotion for products and make it more economical or income generating rather.
Income generating.
Oo.
Mm-hmm. Now, let's proceed, ma'am, sa One Town, One Product. Next generation. Aba, ngayon ko lang mapakinggan yung may dugtong na yan. Familiar sa atin yung OTOP. OTOP o OTOP?
OTOP. One Town.
Yan. One Town, One Product. Ano itong, bakit next generation na, ma'am?
Next generation kasi pinalawig natin yung scope ng ano. So, noon kasi, pagka nag-declare yung isang munisipyo ng kanilang OTOP, yun na lang ang ating sinusupport in mm-hmm. terms of promotion. Mm-hmm. Ito, gumawa tayo ng process. So, first is the OTOP presentation. Second is the development of the product, including the branding and the security of the brand, like patenting, no? Aside from that, we also graduate them to marketing. So we have the OTOP hubs,
okay.
OTOP trade fair, online and virtual and physical. So yun mga from ideation to marketing ang ginagawa natin sa OTOP Next Gen. Okay, yun. Okay.
Para naka 3D pa kayo ba, ma? O ano yun, naka green screen or so iba yung presentation na hanga jikas lang maipresenta yung mga one town one product lang iti a certain display, place or display.
May preparation Sir Eddie. So we have the product development component. After that, we Photoshop them, we put them in a presentation together with the improved packaging and labeling plus the branding and dinadag kung food yan, ina-assist pa natin sila sa FDA licensing para to ensure the safety of our consumers.
Who do the promotion, ma'am? Sorry. Sino ang nagpro-promote sa isang munisipyo? Kayo ba or sila rin
lahat,
or tinuturuan nyo?
Lahat. We call them stakeholders promotion. Lahat ng mga stakeholders involved. So, yung mga municipal executives, yung mga city executives, sila rin yung number one salesman of the products in their area.
Okay.
Plus, of course, the number one promoter of the products are the producers themselves.
Yes, yes.
Tayo naman na enablers, including you, Sir Eddie.
Yes, ma'am.
You're doing your part. Thank you. So we do also a lot of promotion.
Mm-mm. Okay. As far as target clients is concerned, itong promotion ng one town, one product natin, itong OTOP, ma'am, ano yun? More on local, domestic, or hanggang sa ibang bansa? Itong mga foreigners natin?
As much as possible hanggang sa ibang bansa. No? So we also have international platforms like eBay. There are other MSMEs in the Cordillera that are already on board. eBay or ano ba yun? Ibang ano natin platforms, Alibaba.
Okay.
So, yung mga international platforms na ganyan. So gradually as they produce enough quantity for the export and quality, then eventually yun ang ating target sa kanila.
Not to commercialize ba man, no? Siyempre, nandyan yung Lazada, nandyan yung Shopee, and
merchants.
Pwede bang ganun na i-link din natin sila doon or ipasok yung ating mga produkto doon, ma'am?
Yes, the Lazada, we are always in consultation with Lazada as to kung ano yung pwedeng mailagay nila. So, they teach naman our MSMEs kung paano magbenta sa kanila.
Ayun.
So, yung mga e-merchants, yung mga logistics, delivery, like ano yung mga lalamove, mga ganun.
Yes,
no?
Ma'am.
So, and aside from that, financial technology, kasi na-deliver na natin yung produkto, kailangan may bayad yan. So, hindi na magta-travel for bayad. Only the money travels.
Naman. Correct,
sa mga online banking natin.
Basta importante, ma'am, cash on delivery. Kasi marami na yung nag-order ka doon sa social media. Pagbalik, pagdating yung produkto, peke pala. At saka hindi yung nandun sa social media. Diba? Yan. Go local.
Yes, go local. So we have establishment like malls who offer their areas also for the display of our products. And we are happy with this, yung mga malls natin who accommodated them and then give them a place for our display. No, thank you to them kasi marami rin pumupunta.
Yes. That's good. Ano?
Yeah.
And we acknowledge, tama yung sinabi niyo, yung mga partners natin dyan na accommodate, like yung SM, Portabaga,
yes.
na
yes.
pwedeng i-display ang mga produkto ng ating mga kailian. Ma'am, bago yung ating short break, pondo sa pagbabago at pag-asenso program. Ma'am, briefly, paano to?
Yes, that's a special program under our NSB, Negosyo Serbisyo sa Barangay, is still a grassroots approach. And it's still a livelihood seeding program, pero may mga special clients tayo dito. Like yung mga disaster victims, yung LCAC areas for our FRs. Para naman sila to rise up from their economic condition. So aside from that, also other potential MSMEs that are within the barangays.
Okay.
May special fund tayo doon. At saka we are going around again and then looking for potential beneficiaries by 2022.
Okay. Wow. As early as now, may mga na-identify na ba tayo or yes, ongoing pa rin ang screening at identifying would be potential?
Opo, kasi as we want as much as possible na by January, awarding na tayo. So, okay. Ayun po.
Yan. Susundan namin yan, ma'am. Papantayan namin. Mm. Nasa timeline nyo pala yan, ma'am.
Ipo-post namin, ha?
Okay. Tata, amuyo kakailan, iyo man tayo kini director. Dagiti nakita tayo nga pakasiknan ati ado kadagiti kakailan tayo babaan iti segment nga pulso ng publiko. Ito ma'am, may concern tayo with the recent success ng ating mga various programs targeting the youth sector. Kunada, no, adda dagiti kakailan nga mga yatmat ma'am nga agnumar iti reto YEP. We know that ito'y KMME programa nga natalantan tayo itatay. So, anya ka di dito qualifications can dagiti requirements nga nasken nga isagana da. Mabalin ka din nga agpalista tatamam for the next month.
Yes, sir. YEP nga kung Youth Entrepreneurship Program.
Yun.
That's a mind-setting program nga annually we conduct it and then there's preparatory nga 4 modules na dito. So, dagitoy ubing from 18 to 30 years old who are doing as who are already starting to do business iso da dagiti iyak accommodate tayo ditoy but during the mind setting program nga general orientation we accommodate everybody from them ada dagiti agaplayan nga dagiti negosyo dangay nga they are starting with their businesses so dagiti agpalistadan.
Mapadala di opisina yun, ma'am?
Yes. And during the mind-setting activity, kasi mga 300 people dagita niya, so they can already give outright dagiti names, dakan profiles. Da. Mm-hmm. After which, our offices, our provincial offices, will be profiling them and screening them because definitely we can only accommodate just as much. No. Mm-hmm. So, Sir Eddie, as you have said, marami pala, I am happy na as early as now, kot adagayam ti again interest.
Amen.
So we will be, of course, we will be accepting.
Lalo tatanabuya na ma'am niya.
Yeah.
Oh, mm. By the way, when it comes to IEC ma'am, malaksid lang iti intensive nga kayo, press conference or sa showing ninyo, like sa TV or sa radio. Anya pa'y ma'am, tapno makadano mismo dyan, grassroots, iti may isang lugar. Dagito nga programa tayo, anya ti pampamayan tayo ma'am? Nagdo-door-to-door ba tayo or paano?
Number one is social media.
Social
kasi amin pati di barangay ko tagso social media da.
Yun.
Number two, dagitoy business counselors are doing activities at the barangays.
Yun.
10 to 15, so we go there also. Aside from that, of course, we do advocacy through our officials. Mm-mm. And of course, the TV, the printed media or print Mm-mm. media. Also.
Okay. Ma'am, iti sidong tinyo normal. Yan. Iyalalo kayo, iti panag-adaptar, dagiti kakalyan tayo, iti online means, iti panag-negosyo. Magandang tanong to ah. Kasanumat ma'am, no maira na nga isu dakit mabiktima, dagiti makuna nga bogus buyers. Mabalin baka di nga iuman dito iti DTI. O, pag-usapan natin yung mga bogus.
Bogus. Di nga nga gagapir.
Or mga...
naglaing da nga ag-mine, naglaing da nga ag-add to cart. Mm-mm. Ag order into no mapanday delivery handa nga agparang
kawawa or, mga nag
kawawa no? Oh, marami rin umiiyak nag riders tayo no
riders kasi ano ma'am anya ti panang handle
so dagiti mabalinda lata nga ag complain ket no maminsan jay narigat ijay tracing no ay na pang birukan tayo ijay nga bogus buyer so usually we tap also the help of the PNP the our military for to trace them like NBI kat they offered but the services dakat tumultulong damat kanya tayo iti panang biro kadagijay anya na ko na rin agkuskusit ang customers niya
So what's your appeal kadigi manang gundaway nga ko consumer
our appeal is let us develop the culture of honesty in the community. Kasi kakaasi nga di community ngay nga kanayon nga dati kasday, awan to timang cover kanyada nga delivery services.
Yes.
And we will not be able to participate already in online kwan. So let us police each other. So we encourage the culture of honesty.
Okay.
Kaysa tanarigrigat tayong agbirbirok ngay kadagito nga kwan. And the dagiti maamuan mo, dagiti maamuan nga mangluklukho kadagiti riders or dagiti traders nga mangluklukho kadagiti consumers, everybody has the right to send a complaint.
Okay.
Okay.
Lalo kapag naggastos ka matidakkel, binayadan mo tigasto, iti samampat gamgat, fake, ano? Imbes nga authentic or real. Ay nako, mamamalas ka sa negosyo kapag ganun, ma'am. Binayadagdagan mo ng daya. Next week, Madam Director, na ito din nga may SWAT dati, pagsagsaganaan ti DTI kakailan nga Impakabsat Regional Trade Fair.
Yeah.
Please tell us more on this, ma'am.
Yes, we are going back to Alabang. Tad DJ nga over the years kat iso DJ ti nagte-trade fair. And tayo nga tad ado ti gumatgatang EJ products sa iyo from the Cordillera.
Ado?
And we are going back for physical trade fair. Kat ag-open tayo into no November 12 hanggang November 2022. But the opening program will be November 15. And then for this up to two weekends DJ
yes, ma'am.
Nga agkwa. So nagkadugtong. So we are going to sell there all the best products of the Cordillera from all the provinces in the sectors of food, homestyles and wearables. We also have wood-based industries. We also have wearing apparels, no?
Okay.
So ang gaganda ng products natin doon, and even the customers in Manila are excited. And aside from that, what is good now is we have the Facebook Garod ya Impakabsat, inya Impakabsat page. And we have a marketplace there where you can see the products on display, and then ijay kayon mga mabalin nga ag message kadagiti producers.
Mm.
At the same time, during the Impakabsat mismo ta to diffuse dagiti o pag panagumay mo dagiti tattao, they will be on live selling dagiti agmain mo ket adakina sa utay nga ijay nga kwa nga riders,
yes,
nga mga deliver kadagiti household dagiti products.
Okay.
So,
okay.
We are so excited this sa comebacking activity.
Mm. By the way, ma'am, marami tayong mga kakilala, no, in charge iti parang iba't ibang klaseng negosyo niya. Na kapartner tayo, mga entrepreneur na natamaan sa pandemic. Ano yung direkta pala na tulong ni DTI sa kanila, ma'am? Dagitoy nalugi o no nagsarati operasyon di kwa negosyo da.
Okay, so foremost, the DJ offer to you, as I have said earlier, DJ livelihood seeding.
Ayun lang. Oh.
Photo recovery. And then, of course, the DJ P3 cares tayo, iti small business corporation.
He cares.
That give them a low interest loans. Actually, it's non-interest, but we have a little amount of service fee to pay. No, so, ag-apply da lang online, and then they will wait for the processing.
Oh yeah.
Adumatan tinaitid tayo na Sir Eddie kat mga we have a total of 180 million disbursement for the Cordillera.
Do you think dakkelmat nga tulong ta medyo napalag-anen ti panagsarak digay bisita dito sa dati bagi ma'am?
Dakkelmat adumat agigay ma excite mi ngay nga agkas pasalamat piman.
Okay.
Kadagigay.
Wala adto ti no adto sumangat nga bisita. Ado ti magatang nga mga souvenirs.
Yes, yes.
Diyan sa tabi-tabi. Ma'am, please share us also yung activities natin dito ko Cordillera in relation ito yung umadanin nga 50 days to go, Christmas na ma'am.
Yes.
Ano yung mga significant events na DTI initiated?
Okay, foremost DJ Christmas goodies tayo dagiti Noche Buena items tayo ada DJ ko na tayo nga diskwento caravan.
Mm-hmm.
At the same time, aside from that, we will be monitoring also the prices so that they will still be within the suggested retail prices. Dagiti Christmas goodies. Aside from that, adama dagiti trade fair, kadagiti impo-propose dagiti probinsya. So, gumatang tayo iti local products nga itid. Kasi dagiti Sir Eddie napipintas actually. We can compare our products with imported products. I can still vouch nga magagandang ating produkto.
Oy, nato commercialize yung Chongsan ano, Bonanza, Sari-Sari Store Bonanza. Every year yan nandiyan ang DTI na sumusuporta.
Yes, because yun po yung ating sinasabing diskwento at saka rolling store.
Ayun.
Na to offer them at discounted prices. Para maganda naman ang ating Christmas, no? Ang ating Christmas. At Sir Eddie, I should not forget this because this November is Ibagu month.
No? Ibagu so, yung ilan sa Creative Festival ng Baguio.
Yes, we are so supportive to the Creative City by the following programs like Impakabsat is number one.
Okay.
We are bringing Creative City to other areas. Another one is Mandeco Quito. Yes, ma'am. That is man, that is an Ibolay term for manlakot ako. Mm-hmm. No? So that is let's buy here. Another one is of course the Creative Fridays for artisans and craftsmen. We will have a series of capability building seminars every Fridays. Mm-hmm. And adapan ba nalipatak? That is Creative City.
Ken dadto mapay nga event.
Ken dadto mapay nga event.
Yung website yun na lang. Baka dapay tap na makita da yung website yung ma'am.
Ah, of course there is the Impakabsat page and the Mandiko Kito page and then of course the Ibagaw page. So tatlo yan, sir.
All
they
right.
just go around it, but it's full of ano information ngayon sa social media.
Yan, please visit ah. Yun po ang kanilang legit. Yan. Sana hindi ma-hack yung hindi na-hack.
Ay, hindi.
Ardi, madam. Sakbay ming alaan dati kang runaan nga mensahe yung parting words nyo sa ating mga viewers. At ito'y paimante, may isang segmento yung anawagan nga, serbisyo mo, rate mo. Ma'am, itinasurok ka, may isang atawan nyo nga pa nagsirbi ka sa regional director. At the same time, 4 months. Ano? Ilang taon kayong bilang ARD? 4 years?
Hindi. Mga
dalawang taon.
This October, last
okay.
October.
Tapos ngayong 4 months into your stint as the daulo ng DTI, andiyan tipa na makunayo, tipa nang ipaayot iservisyo, ganito na lang, if we rate 1 to 10, 10 is the highest, so how will you gauge?
My services.
Yes, service nyo or service ng DTI agency. As a whole, ng agency.
We have been very tired. We have been doing a lot of effort, so I say 10.
Okay,
we did our best.
Confidently
yes.
Saying na 10. Wow.
So when we did our best, that is to me 10.
Palakpakan niyo naman si
yeah.
Ma'am.
Okay.
Yeah. 10, oh.
That's up to you to judge us. If there are inadequacies of what we have provided, then of course we can fill it up with subsequent interventions, sir.
Okay. You're confident enough to say that, ma'am, with the support ng inyo pong team members, and taong bayan, kasi alam nyo naman kung paano nyo ginagawa ang inyong trabaho. At the same time, bago po naman po ang inyong commitment, ang inyong pong final word, just to acknowledge ang inyong team na kasama rito, si Sir Ron Rosuelio and Glonica Favorito, ang inyong pong mga designated information officers.
Yes.
Salamat, ma'am, at pinapunta nyo po ang inyong team dito. Now, unless otherwise, mayroon pa kayong pahabol, pero again, maraming salamat po sa lahat po mga nanood, lalo na yung mga mga youth natin na magbabalak magnegosyo.
Yeah.
Okay. Ma'am, I'll give you the floor. Ang inyo pong mensahe or ang inyo pong commitment as a whole ng Department of Trade and Industry at ang inyong pakiusap na rin or appeal and everything sa ating mga suki sa isyu at serbisyo. Go ahead, Director Lucas.
Thank you very much, Sir Eddie. And to all the listeners of isyu at serbisyo dito sa PTV, I am so happy and privileged nga inmayak ditoy to give information about what we are doing at the Department of Trade and Industry. Rest assured, we are doing our very best to be of service to you at the mandate that we are capable of doing. And my appeal, Sir Eddie, is let us buy local. Let us patronize our own local businesses. I know they are better and they are safer, Sir Eddie. And as consumers, let us also be responsible consumers, but at the same time, very vigilant and assert our rights as consumers para hindi po tayo maloko. Kasi at times, both sides, may manloloko at may naloloko. And of course, what we are trying to do here is safety and protection. And at the same time, progressive businesses with the interventions of the many programs of government, including the Department of Trade and Industry. Thank you very much and good afternoon to everyone.
Our pleasure, ma'am. Matago-tago. Takuam in. Ma'am Juliet Lucas, ang ating Regional Director ng Department of Trade and Industry, buy local and support local. Agtultuloy kakailian, ang mga ipapaay, tibalanse, kendi kalidad a serbisyo kada itinegosyante, diterisyon. Tapno, may pasigurado ken may panamnamay tinapintas nga kapadasan ti tunggal consumer. Dagita iti kagkagumaan nga akman ti Department of Trade and Industry Cordillera. Katindulong, iti panagasenso iti negosyo. Kabinadang kailan, iti panangi sigurado iti kinatalgad ti publiko agumatgatang iti produkto ken serbisyo. Agyaman kami papagayam, iti hinkay panang tarabay iti programa tayo tamalim. Ingganay iti sumarunong nga nabara kinapuan kay papanan na diskusyon dito'y isyu at serbisyo siya ka po ni Eddie Carta, ni Bagamalam. Director Lucas, magandang hapon. Back, mabuhay. Thank you.